Progress 38 docking issues, and far, far away flags on your SpacePod for July 6th, 2010. On July 2nd, 2010, an automated docking of the Progress 38 resupply vehicle to the International Space Station failed. The Progress vehicle launched aboard a Soyuz rocket at the Baikonur Cosmodrome on Wednesday, June 30th, 2010. About 25 minutes prior to docking, problems cropped up. An interference issue between the automated KURS system and the manual TORU system seems to have caused the abort. About an hour after the problem started, Russian managers told the crew to just stand down for the day. At this point, international news teams started having an absolute field day with this.
And again, we're just collecting information about what we were hearing of something going on in space. An unmanned vehicle, a vessel, I should say, was trying to dock with the International Space Station. Something went wrong and it wasn't able to dock, so it's up there right now, if you will. There's no danger to the astronauts on the International Space Station. There's no danger, he said, even to the planet Earth, quite frankly, because it will just eventually burn up in the atmosphere. But that's the latest we're getting from NASA. Quick break here in the CNN newsroom. We're right back.
It's a good thing you guys fired your science reporters. Wouldn't want you to sound dumb or spread misinformation.
A Russian supply spacecraft has failed to dock at the International Space Station. This is the first time this has ever happened in history.
You also say, of course, this is an unusual incident. Actually, it hasn't happened before, has it, in the history of the ISS?
Absolutely, this has not happened before, ever.
Huh. Well, that's just plain wrong. While Progress vehicles have had docking issues with the ISS before, heck, even as recent as May of this year, generally they just switch to the TORU manual docking mechanism and all is fine. But even outside of that, the Progress vehicle has had serious problems docking before, just not with the ISS. On June 25th, 1997, while running a TURS system test, a Progress vehicle came in too fast and slammed into the Mir space station. Not only did this vehicle not dock, but it damaged the space station, causing emergency decompression and throwing Mir into an uncontrolled spin.
We thought there was a collision imminent. The thought in our minds was we are going to have to bail out. And I was the first one to go per the procedures to the Soyuz, and there I waited. Then, as it became apparent that it wasn't a devastating puncture of the hull of Spectre module, and that we had time to work and try and isolate it, then I came out of the Soyuz, understood implicitly that we were not going to be abandoning quite yet, and we then proceeded to work together. I was Sasha Lazutkin to clear cables and hold a hatch in place over that module's entranceway.
So, yeah, they've had issues docking the Progress vehicle before. Of course, in this case, there was no collision, and everyone was safe the entire time. The Progress vehicle noted the issue, went into safe mode, fly past the ISS at a safe distance of about 3 kilometers or 1.8 miles. On Saturday, some course correction changes were uploaded to the vehicle. Then on Sunday, July 4th at 16:17 Coordinated Universal Time, the Progress vehicle safely docked with the International Space Station. Now, Progress 38 is carrying 2.6 tons of fuel, food, water, and supplies for the six Expedition 24 crew members aboard station. A few minutes of scary, followed by engineering pulling out the awesome to get the craft docked safely with ISS. That's how space goes. Of course, before we go, it's kind of cool to think that this last 4th of July, the American flag furthest from its home country of the U.S. wasn't on foreign soil, wasn't on the ISS, and it wasn't even on the moon. The furthest American flag out there is about 17 billion kilometers, or 10.5 billion miles, traveling aboard the Voyager 1 spacecraft. The next furthest flag out there is aboard Voyager 2, which is just under 14 billion kilometers, or 8.5 billion miles. How far away is that? Well, so far that each craft is leaving our home solar system. How's that for awesome?